All right, and away we go. I've been trying to come up with some way to be helpful in the world. It is really exceedingly difficult right now. And it just occurred to me, the Holy Spirit put something into my mind, and so it, what occurred is that the way to do it is to let everyone know that if someone's enlightened, that those that come to them, they come to them without any intellectual goal in mind, simply to experience the overall context of the situation, just to experience, that's it. No intellectual goals at all. Don't hold any intellectual goals. Otherwise, that short circuits the whole situation. Because the understanding that ultimately you get is so far beyond what the egoic intellect can remotely understand or agree to, that if you come with intellectual goals, it's a total barrier, a total barrier. So sure, some might say, ah, no, what are you talking about? You're trying to trick me or something. The ego gets very nervous about that. But others will say, okay, let's just do it. Let's just do it. And this way, there's some sort of, something seeps into us, okay? And we say, wow, this is different than the egoic agenda. This is not the mind of the flesh. This is the mind of the spirit. The mind of the flesh and the mind of the spirit are at cross purposes with one another. And the goddess coming in and saying, oh, she can reconcile the two, is not true at all. It's not true at all. You need to decide to set one down and pick the other up. You cannot reconcile mutual exclusives. Okay. So, first of all, set down the idea that you can reconcile mutual exclusives. Then also say, I'm not coming with any intellectual agenda or purpose to get some intellectual answers at all. Now, if some sort of clarity arises, great. And it will. It will. But the clarity will say, wow, this is a different way of looking at something. I've always looked at it this way. And now suddenly I'm seeing it this way. What happens is, we've been looking at it through the mind of the flesh, okay? Through the belief system of the flesh, which is really just spiritual arrogance. And then we shift over and we see it through the belief system of the Spirit, of the Holy Spirit, which is setting down our arrogance, and which is the mind of repentance, setting down arrogance, mind of forgiveness. And we see it differently. This is what happens. But to come with an intellectual goal, the goal of the ego, the belief system of the flesh, of arrogance really, you can never get from arrogance, can never reach the understanding that spirit has. Okay, it can never reach it. So it's futile to go about it that way. This is why just quiet sitting without any agenda is so very helpful. So very, very helpful. First, we have to put down that intellectual agenda that we have in the world right now is being driven by the mind of the flesh, isn't it? By intellectual agendas, emotional agendas, emotional / intellectual, egoic, arrogant agendas. And there's no way you can use that to actually see how the spirit views the situation. Now, I'm going to use an example here, which is quite important. Should be very illustrative here. We're going to switch over to a graphic here. This is the famous Matthew 5:25, the famous agree with thine adversary quickly, whilst thou art in the way with him, lest at any time the adversary deliver thee to the judge, and the judge deliver thee to the officer, and thou be cast into prison. And it goes on saying, and you will not get free in any way until you've paid the very, very, you know, last farthing or last bit of it. Now, it's very interesting. This is a King James version. I picked the King James because I read the others. You go to Bible Hub and there's all these different different Bibles that are modernized and new standard this and American this and this and this, this and that. And I found that they had lost the meaning of this, really gone far astray. The King James version. A lot of times the King James version is better, actually. I wouldn't say all the time, but I noticed that quite a bit of the time, it's much more accurate. It gives a better, it's less of the flesh interpreting what is said. The mind of the flesh is less involved in the King James Version. So here, we at least have some room for the Spirit to say, hey, you know, we say it's not, let's see what Jesus is saying. Well, I don't know. The first thing to say is, I don't know what Jesus is saying. I don't know. I've always said this. I say, you know, I don't know what he's saying. But I do know that I don't quite understand what he's saying. Okay, that's one thing I do know. What I know is, whatever he's saying, I feel that there's some greater depth to it than what the mind of the flesh is trying to tell me. The mind of the flesh, of course, will say, like the New Standard Version will say, oh yeah, while you're on your way to the courtroom with your legal opponent who has a claim against you, try to settle the matter quickly before you get to court. Otherwise, the judge may judge against you, and you're going to have to, you know, be put in prison and pay. For in other words, they turn into a legalistic, like Jesus is giving a social advice about how to deal with legal matters, like a good rabbi, you know, that kind of thing, explaining the law to you, how to get along with the law. If you get into a dispute, you know, try to settle it before you get to court. And people say, oh yeah. You know, that's what he's talking about. And I'm saying, I'm feeling like, whoa, wait a minute. I have my doubts that that's what Jesus is talking about. I always find that what Jesus says is just super, super profound, that he's talking in a spiritual language. He's talking not to the mind of the flesh, but to the mind of spirit. Okay. And so the legalistic interpretation of this is, you know, out the window. Forget it. That's not what he's talking about at all. Now, I happen to have come across something quite amazing that may illustrate what's being said here. And that is, I've started this practice of saying negative assertions in a positive way, like agreeing with them, to take out all value of this dream, this simulation that that Spirit's imagination is projecting, which is this universe. It's actually a simulation that's preparing us for this believed in start of the time and the kingdom of time, how it will be for us when we're living in the kingdom of time, which will never happen. But we're making this, our spiritual mind is projecting this scenario we call a universe and bodies and worlds, etc., as a way to prepare spirit, to prepare itself for dwelling in what it believes will be the kingdom of time once spirit is able to start time, which really means once spirit's able to change reality, which will be never, okay, never. We cannot, the Son of God cannot change the will of God, the prime creator. It's not possible. It doesn't have that power at all. So, the way to awaken from this dream, to set it down, is to take out all the value from it. So instead of trying to pump up the hero or heroine of this dream, like they're going to accomplish something great, and that through that accomplishment of something great, that then that hero or heroine of the dream is going to feel happy and satisfied with the dream and be able to live in this dream and think it's reality, and they'll be well adjusted to time when it starts. Instead of doing that, use negative assertions talking about how terrible the dream is and how you'll never find satisfaction here and how all situations are ruinous for you. Say, all my circumstances are ruinous. All my situations are impossible, you know, which is ultimately true about the dream. Okay, the dream is really much ado about absolutely nothing. Nothing will ever work out here in that way. So in doing these assertions, it's a very advanced practice, and you have to be very mature to not get caught up in the level confusion with this. Anyway, I've done it now three times, testing it out on myself like a guinea pig. And so far, so good. In fact, each time it becomes way more profound, and I've actually gone into an even more profound practice, which was this morning. I woke up at 3 in the morning, and I started practicing. And for hours and hours and hours, what I did was I took the position of like the ego and how I know how critical it is of spirit. And I've experienced this, and I used all these accusations that the ego will use against spirit, against truth. And I agreed with every single one of them. Like the ego would say, you're absolutely worthless. And then I would say, yes, And I would agree with the ego. I say, yes, I'm absolutely worthless. The ego says, you're absolutely a vicious killer. And I'd say, yes, I'm absolutely a vicious killer. And the ego would say, you're completely stupid. And I'd say, yes, I'm completely stupid. And the ego would, so this went on and on and on for hours. The ego would say, you're completely insane. And I'd say, yes, I'm completely insane. But I said it like happy, like, yes, I'm completely insane. Yes, I'm completely stupid. Yes, I'm completely worthless. Yes, I'm a total loser. Yes, I'll never do anything good whatever. Yes, and so whatever negative assertion you can make about yourself. Yes, I'm completely ugly. Yes, I'm just a worthless fool. Yes. Everything that was said, I agreed with it. Immediately. Never didn't think about it. Immediately I said, yes, I agree with whatever the ego said. I agree with it immediately. So the ego says, you're teaching falsely. I says, yes, I'm teaching falsely. And then the ego said, but you said you're teaching truly. You said you're teaching truly. I said, yes, I'm teaching truly. And then the ego say, well, you're a deceiver then. I said, yes, I'm a deceiver. And the ego said, you're teaching conflicting messages. Yes, I'm teaching conflicting messages. Well, you're a liar. Yes, I'm a liar. And, you know, the ego kept trying to trap me. And whatever it said, I just kept this complete poise, immediately agreeing with whatever it said. In a nice, positive, happy way. Yes, I'm a liar. And the ego would say, you don't believe in truth. I say, yes, I don't believe in truth. And the ego would say, you're totally confused. I'd say, yes, I'm totally confused. The ego would say, you can't help anyone. I say, yes, I can't help anyone. And this went on for hours and hours. Just every negative, any negativity that I could hurl at myself, I hurled it at myself and responded with this very centered and poised yes. Just agreed with whatever it said, just agree with it. Now this was, I've never, you know, done this in my life. I don't think this has ever occurred to hardly anybody. I've never heard of anybody doing this sort of practice. I mean, it's funny, in the daytime I heard this advertisement for bullying. They're starting to put all these advertisements on the radio about bullying. And you know, they had these kids saying, today I went to school and I thought I wanted to learn, but somebody said I was fat. You know, today somebody said that I don't have any friends, and today somebody said that, you know, I'm ugly. You know, now, okay, so that there's a big campaign going on with bullying, and I said, wow, they're not approaching it in the right way. It's the mind of the flesh that is giving the advice, which is wrong advice. What we should train ourselves in. And this could ultimately trickle down to the children too, once we have proved it to ourselves, is say to ourselves, hey, I'm extremely ugly, and then say, yes, I'm extremely ugly, and then say, well, I don't have any friends. Yes, I don't have any friends. You're very fat. Yes, I'm very fat. And smiling, yeah, agree with whatever said, agree, yes. Yes, no matter what it is. Like a parrot, just parrot. Yes, I agree. No matter what is said. You're a great king. Yes, I'm a great king. You're a complete loser. Yes, I'm a complete loser. So the ego just tries to throw you off somehow. And I did really well. I only remember like one, finally the ego got to something that bothered me a little bit. It took hours and hours and hours. Most of the stuff didn't bother me the slightest bit. You can say, yes, ego say, you're a terrible bully. Yes, I'm a terrible bully. You're a really sick person. Yes, I'm a really sick person. You should be killed. Yes, I should be killed. You should be crucified. Yes, I should be crucified. Okay, but no reaction. I mean, there's no reaction from me. I was just agreeing. That's it. And then just completely calm. No thoughts were taking place at all. This is the agreeing game, the agreeing practice. Okay. Now, again, this was just amazingly profound. I just stunned. I said, wow, I thought all this stuff the ego was berating with, I was going to crush me. It didn't crush me at all. It was like water off a duck's back. And again, I hurled every malevolent charge you could think of at myself. You know, just horrible stuff. You know, you're the most wicked person in history. Yes, I'm the most wicked person in history. You're the Antichrist. Yes, I'm the Antichrist. And then the ego says, you're the Christ. I say, yes, I'm the Christ. And it says, well, you're an egomaniac. Yes, I'm an egomaniac. You should be quiet. Yes, I should be quiet. And the ego says, well, you're still talking. Yes, I'm still talking. Well, then you're not following your own advice. Yes, I'm not following my own advice. Well, I can't agree with anything you say. Yes, you can't agree with anything I say. No matter what is said, you just say yes. Yeah, and repeat it. Yes, that's right. Yes, yes, I agree. So it's agreeing. But I was doing it instantly. I was doing it instantly. I didn't think about it at all. I was doing it instantly. Whatever the ego wants to say is fine with me. Yes, I agree. Because ultimately it's just I am. So everything the ego is saying has basically nothing to do with me at all. So why judge between what's being said about you? The ego has no idea what you are. So instead of arguing with the ego, well, and going to judgment, don't go into any judgment whatsoever. Immediately agree. And then it came in my mind, I said, hey, this sounds similar to what Jesus said. Agree with thine adversary quickly, lest ye be brought before the judge, I think. Let me see. Agreeing with thine adversary quickly, whilst thou art in the way with him, lest at any time the adversary deliver thee to the judge. Okay, what is Jesus talking about here? He's talking about a spiritual, mental situation, how the ego accuses us, constantly actually makes us afraid of its accusations, and tries to get us into judgment. Okay, judgment. So deliver thee to the judge. Jesus is talking about here judgment. He's using a sort of a way of talking to them. See, Jesus spoke in a way where those who thought about the mind of the flesh wouldn't understand him through the mind of the flesh. But those who listen to the mind of Spirit, Holy Spirit, would gradually be able to understand what he said. And he actually, when he talked to crowds, he'd use parables, various ways of talking, parables. And then he would talk to his apostles away from the crowd and explain to them what he really meant. That's what he did. So there's really two levels of Jesus' teaching. One, he gave a parable of like saying, they asked him, why do you talk this way? He said, because so they won't understand what I'm really talking about. Because they're not ready. And they'll go away. And then he'd tell the apostles, explain, this is what I was saying. This is what I was saying. And they say, oh, okay. So you almost have like two types of Christianity, that which listens to the Holy Spirit, and that which keeps trying to take what Jesus said literally and interpret through the mind of the flesh, and they come up with, you know, all these very, you know, their interpretations of the mind of the flesh, which are not the same as the mind of Spirit, Holy Spirit. So I found that I was doing the very practice what Jesus suggests, because I was agreeing with my adversary, the ego, the voice of arrogance, immediately. I didn't let any time interlapse, no argumentation, nothing. Whatever the ego accused me of, I agreed with. The ego would say, you're guilty of dreadful crimes. I say, yes, I'm guilty of dreadful crimes. The ego would say, you should be severely punished. I say, yes, I should be severely punished. You should be ostracized. I say, yes, I should be ostracized. The ego said, you should be cast into prison. I said, yes, I should be cast into prison. The ego says, God hates you. I said, yes, God hates me. The ego says, you will never be free of suffering. I said, yes, I'll never be free of suffering. You're going to be cast into hell. I said, yes, I'm going to be cast into hell. And so all I'm focusing on is immediately agreeing with whatever diabolical statement the ego can make, whatever accusation, the accuser, agree with thine adversary, the accuser, quickly, immediately. So now I understand what Jesus is talking about in this statement that he made. And it's quite different than the modern day Christian Bible Christian Bibles talk about it tends to paint it like a Jesus' advice about how to deal with disagreements here in the world and not to before you get to the judge, etc., blah blah blah. That's not what Jesus is saying, and based on what I've experiencing now, he's really pointing to a very advanced type of practice here. Okay, now it didn't seem like Jesus told us to practice too much. You could do the Lord's Prayer, etc. But really, in A Course in Miracles, he absolutely says practicing is essential. Essential. It's just we haven't been willing to do it so much. I found out that that is true. So he really, though, was setting us up to practice. This is pointing to this practice of agreeing and of intentionally accusing yourself of all this, you know, whatever you can to trip yourself up and then just agreeing and not being tripped up at all by it. You can call yourself whatever bad words, like the racist, all these words today. The ego said, you're a racist. I say, yes, I'm a racist. You're sexist. Yes, I'm sexist. You're bigoted. Yes, I'm bigoted. You're intolerant. Yes, I'm intolerant. There's all these buzzwords the millennials are using. I guess it's pretty much... They think they're words of power or something, but they like to use these words. And so the ego loves these words, they're supposed to paralyze you. And so you just happily agree, absolutely. Yes, absolutely. And gradually I found out the ego was like shocked by all this. It was shocked and almost stunned into silence. He just said, it's like, what's going on here? I want to get into an argument. I want him to get into judgment. He's not going into judgment, argument. What's going on? In other words, the agenda that the ego is really after, which is judgment, trying to induce God into judgment, is the whole project universe, is an attempt to induce God into judgment. That's what our arrogance is trying to do. So you have to realize that God is not induced into judgment whatsoever, okay? Because There's nothing about time to judge, because time never started, never will. There's nothing to judge. To induce God into judgment is God saying that time did start, okay, or will start, which would mean that reality is going to be changed. And so we keep trying to, our arrogance keeps trying to induce God into judgment. So since we are one with God, we're the creation of God, so we're Spirit, Son of God, any inducement of us into judgment is also, we believe that God has been induced into judgment. So the ego is hurling these insults at you, trying to get you to say, hey, now, wait a minute, I'm not that bad, and the ego says, well, okay, let's take a look at this and see, let's bring some judgment to bear, meaning the law, the judgment, the mental judgment here. So the way to practice towards true spiritual liberation is to agree with whatever the ego charges you with. Now, when Jesus was brought before Pontius Pilate, they said, what do you say? And he didn't defend himself, did he? He didn't defend himself. He didn't say anything, really. He said, he basically, you say this. He said, you're the king of the Jews, or you say that, or whatever. And he just, basically, Jesus did not defend himself. If you say it. There's this profound practice of agreeing with whatever your adversary says quickly. So if the adversary says, you should be crucified, say, yes, I should be crucified. You should be reviled. Yes, I should be reviled. You should be bullied. Yes, I should be bullied. You should be mocked. Yes, I should be mocked. You should be scorned. Yes, I should be scorned. And just keep on doing this. I did it for hours after hour after hour, trying to come up with just whatever accusation I could hurl at myself. I hurled it at myself. The most wicked, terrible stuff you can imagine, so to speak. And I just agreed with every bit of it. You're a terrible drug addict. Yes, I'm a terrible drug addict. You have no self-control. Yes, I have no self-control. You need to be annihilated. Yes, I need to be annihilated. See? And just completely calm, relaxed. Yeah, that's it. Don't even. And so here we have this amazing practice that simply stuns the ego. And we can see how this is really what Jesus is saying when he spoke about this in Matthew 5:25. Agree with your adversary quickly while you're in the way with him. While the ego's making this accusation, instantly agree with it. Yes. Otherwise, this adversary, the ego, is going to pull your mind into judgment. And then the judgment is going to deliver you into self-condemnation, the officer, and you'll be cast into prison, in the prison this dualistic, of arrogance. The prison of arrogance, really, is what this is. Terrible prison of arrogance, believing that you're the body. And so this has been quite an extraordinary situation that has developed around this practicing that I've been doing, of these negative, hurling these negative assertions at myself. Like, I'm never going to escape this dream. I said, yes, I'm never going to escape this dream. I mean, use it like as an accusation. You are never going to escape this dream. Yes, I'm never going to escape this dream. You are incapable of awakening. Yes, I'm incapable of awakening. And the ego gets so flustered because it wants a dialogue. And you're like this robot parrot just saying, yes, yes, I agree with everything you say, I'm just going to agree with. That's it. Never going to argue whatsoever. So if we taught this method to our children, to ourselves and to our children, this would be a social revolution, actually, of extremely helpful social revolution. But there's this obsession by, you know, the baby boomers, Generation X, millennials, this last, you know, three or so generations. I'm actually a tweener. It's just sort of the end of the baby boom and before whatever Generation X or whatever. I don't know how exactly you call that, but where I don't really fit into any generation. But these generations have pushed this agenda to an extraordinary extent, the mind of the flesh. They've decided that the mind of spirit is just too tough of a nut to crack for them. And with all this wealth and luxury and medications and everything, you know, the sex, the drugs, the rock and roll, my gosh, they said, you know, why spend your lifetime struggling with trying to figure out what the Holy Spirit is trying to convey to us, you know, when we can just kind of, you know, have this endless summer of fleshy indulgence here. And so they basically threw in the towel. And of course, this doesn't solve anything. And now they're struck with this bullying problem that they're obsessed about it. They're obsessed with this. And it's really quite bizarre. I mean, anyone who's grown up in this world goes through ups and downs as you're growing up. And you know, it's not easy growing up, but now they're like, you know, making this huge, you know, this practice here is an extraordinary practice. And what if the children grew up and the parents were practicing this and they saw the parents smile when anyone cursed them? They say, yes, you're absolutely right. Someone says, you're just a complete idiot. You know, you don't even deserve to live. And say, yes, I'm a complete idiot, and I don't deserve to live. And then just smile. Like, I just smile, and I'm happy with it. Great. Love it. You know, the kids will see that and say, wow, my parents aren't even bothered in the slightest bit by all this, you know, people cursing and mocking them, et cetera. And then the kid would realize, I can practice this too. And then they would grow up like, wow, none of this world bothers me. Whatever anyone says doesn't even cause a ripple in me, you see. So they're going about it the wrong way. Of course, they're going about everything the wrong way here. When you try to solve our problem, which is the problem of spiritual arrogance. When you try to solve it through the mind of the flesh, you're doomed to fail. And we can use this as practice. The ego will say, you're doomed to fail. I'll say, yes, I'm doomed to fail. Because it's really talking about the Holy Spirit. The ego criticizing is really talking about the Holy Spirit, the mind of spirit saying, you're doomed to fail. And so, you see, you say, yes, I'm doomed to fail. Really, meaning say, whatever you say, ego, doesn't bother me at all. You see? Because you have no idea what you're talking about. So, I just might as well just agree with everything. It's all the same anyway. It's all the same nonsense. When there's a lunatic talking, you know, you just smile and agree. You know, the lunatic says, you're a real lunatic, aren't you? And you say, yes, I'm a real lunatic, yes. And the lunatic says, yeah, you're in an insane asylum, aren't you? Yes, I'm in an insane asylum. Mm-hmm. And the lunatic says, wow, you must be on some heavy medication. Yes, I must be on some very heavy medication. And the lunatic says, wow, you really need a lot of therapy. Say, yes, I really need a lot of therapy. And the lunatic says, oh man, you're a hopeless basket case. Say, yes, I'm a hopeless basket case. And the lunatic says, you know what, I think I can help you. Yes, I think you can help me. And the lunatic says, well, you know, first you got to realize that you're damned. Yes, I realize that I'm damned. And like that. So whatever the ego says is talking about, it's talking about that truth isn't true, okay, essentially. So whatever it says, just agree with it quickly. This is a very profound practice. And if you try it, you may shock yourself, because you may feel like, wow, this really doesn't bother me at all. People say, you're just such a very terrible, you're such a coward, aren't you? You're such a coward. Yes, I'm such a coward. You're so disrespectful. Yes, I'm so disrespectful. You're really a terrible smart aleck, aren't you? Yes, I'm really a terrible smart aleck, yes. I says, wow. You're trying to mock me. Yes, I'm trying to mock you. He says, well, you know, the ego says, well, who am I dealing with? What am I dealing with here? This, I'm not really getting anywhere. And it will think like, oh, what can I say to really upset them? I can't find something to upset them. So it tries, you know, keeps trying different stuff to upset you. And you don't have any upset at all. You're not the slightest bit upset. You're really just a pathetic loser, aren't you? Yes, I'm really a pathetic loser. Oh, your problem is you don't trust in God, do you? Yes, I don't trust in God. You're not able to understand truth. Yes, I'm not able to understand truth. You'll never amount to anything. Yes, I'll never amount to anything. Nobody's ever going to like you. Yes, nobody's ever going to like me. And see, so all this, it doesn't even cause a ripple in me right now, you know? Just like, in fact, it's great. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you for helping me practice. This is very helpful. So, agree with your adversary quickly. Okay, agree with your adversary quickly. This is a profound practice. And here is something else that Jesus has said. But I say unto you, love your enemies, bless them that curse you, do good to them that hate you, and pray for them which despitefully use you and persecute you. Okay, now he's really digging into this about those who hate you. You know, someone will say, you're so hateful, I hate you. Yes, I'm hateful. I'm hateful. Yes, I'm hateful. I despise you. Yes, yes. You're despicable. Yes, I'm despicable. You're trying to tear me down. Yes, I'm trying to tear you down. You're trying to attack me. Yes, I'm trying to attack you. You're so fear-based. Yes, I'm so fear-based. You're trying to be separate. Yes, I'm trying to be separate. See? So you keep doing this, and this is dissipating guilt. It's not allowing yourself to be pulled into judgment is what it's doing. Profoundly helpful practice. And you maybe go back and think about your life, all the times that you got flustered when people, you know, tried to throw a guilt trip on you. So sometimes spiritual people, in fact, a lot of times, both secular and spiritual, which are often two sides of the same coin here. The mind of the flesh can claim all sorts of facets, you know, secular, atheist, religious, spiritual, new age, blah, blah, blah. And it's all just the mind of the flesh, you know, and okay, so you can have all these guilt trips laid upon you. Someone says, "You're trying to separate from me." Yes, I'm trying to separate from you. Well, you're going to lay all this guilt trip on yourself. Yes, I'm going to lay a guilt trip on myself. Well, don't you want to avoid that? Yes, I want to avoid that. Don't you want to do what I advise you? Yes, I want to do what you advise me. Well, don't you want to join this? Yes, I want to join this. Well, then why are you quitting? Well, but you're a quitter now. Yes, I'm a quitter. But you just said you wanted to join me. Yes, I want to join you. Why are you? But you're quitting. Yes, I'm quitting. Well, that doesn't make any sense. Yes, I don't make any sense. I mean, you're talking nonsense. Yes, I'm talking nonsense. How come you can't make a decision, can you? Yes, I can't make a decision. Well, there's something wrong with you. Yes, there's something wrong with me. Yeah, you need some help. Yes, I need some help. Wow, you're really weird. Yes, I'm really weird. Now you're just totally bizarre. Yes, I'm totally bizarre. Okay, I think you better just go. Yes, I better just go. You're just wicked. Yes, I'm just wicked. You're trying to, you know, trying to confuse me. Yes, I'm trying to confuse you. So the ego's thinking like, what's going on here? I can't figure it out. I just can't figure it out. Yes, you can't figure me out. Well, do you have anything to say? Yes, I have something to say. What is it? What can you say? Yes, what can I say? Wait, what, you don't have anything to say? No, I don't have anything to say. Well, you just said you did have something to say. Yes, I have something to say. Wait, but you're not saying anything. No, I'm not saying anything. Yes, I'm not saying anything. And again, the ego's like, oh, wow, you know, just... It's like melting the ego, you know, the mind of the ego is just being melted, evaporated. You're trying to throw a guilt trip on me, aren't you? Yes, I'm trying to throw a guilt trip on you. But you're not doing what Jesus told you to do, are you? No, I'm not doing what Jesus told me to do. Yeah. Well, you should repent. Yes, I should repent. Will you repent? Yes, I will repent. You don't seem like you're repenting, though. No, I'm not repenting. Yes, I'm not repenting. What's the matter? You don't have a mind? Yes, I don't have a mind. Well, you don't have any spirit, then. Yes, I don't have any spirit. Well, you must be soulless, then. Yes, I am soulless. Well, God is going to destroy you, then. Yes, God is going to destroy me. Well, you deserve to be destroyed, that's for sure. Yes, I deserve to be destroyed, that's for sure. You see, the ego's not getting anywhere, is it? And then, but, you know, who can practice this way? You know, the mind of flesh will never practice this way. Never. It might do it for a kick a little bit, but it will never practice this way. It can't. It cannot. Because it's inherently weak, fearful, defensive. It's nothing. It's preparing for what will never happen, which, of course, is absurd. And the ego will say, well, you're absurd. Yes, I'm absurd. You're whimsical. Yes, I'm whimsical. You're arrogant. Yes, I'm arrogant. Nobody should listen to you. Yes, nobody should listen to me. You need to be locked up. Yes, I need to be locked up. But again, the ego is really aiming for judgment. Okay, it's trying to induce judgment into you. When you engage in judgment, you think that God engages in judgment too. And then you become fearful, absolutely fearful. Because you believe that God believes that reality can be changed, which really means you can be annihilated. Reality can be annihilated. So love your enemies. Okay. In other words, don't argue with the enemy. The enemy is calling, saying that you're persecuting. I said, you know, you're just swine. You should get sick and die. Yes, I should get sick and die. You need to be on some heavy meds. Yes, I need to be on some heavy meds. You're a danger to society. Yes, I'm a danger to society. Well, we can't have that. Yes, you can't have that. No judgment in the mind. No judgment's happening at all. No judgment. No judgment. So the ego's like, he gets all freaked out. You're freaking me out. Yes, I'm freaking you out. You're trying to hurt me. Yes, I'm trying to hurt you. You're trying to help me. Yes, I'm trying to help you. Now you're speaking a double message. Yes, I'm speaking a double message. Oh, you're conflicted. Yes, I'm conflicted. Well, you need to change your mind. Yes, I need to change my mind. You go on and on and on and on. You can go on hours like this. And then you really realize what the ego is up to when you do this dialogue like this. Because the ego is trying to trap you. It's trying to trap you into judgment. This is what it's doing. So Jesus says, love your enemies. Love those that despise you. Bless those that despise you. Pray for those that persecute you. Always positive. Yes. Yes. Whatever you say. Yes. I agree. You're a child of Satan. Yes, I'm a child of Satan. You can never know God. You will never know God. Yes, I will never know God. You can't be saved. Yes, I can't be saved. You are totally damned. Yes, I'm totally damned. You're a smug wretch. Yes, I'm a smug wretch. You don't belong here. Yes, I don't belong here. You need to disappear. Yes, I need to disappear. So every response is the same. The same attitude. No judgment. Yes, just agree. So Jesus is pointing out this extraordinarily profound practice that we can absolutely do. And I've done it. I've been doing it now. 3 times I've been doing this, this practice of negative statements. And it's led to this format of the ego, you know, condemning you or saying something to you and then agreeing with it like this as being a very helpful way. The ego will say, you stand absolutely condemned. Yes, I stand absolutely condemned. You have absolutely no capacity to help yourself. Yes, I have absolutely no capacity to help myself. You are totally helpless. Yes, I am totally helpless. You are totally fearful. Yes, I am totally fearful. You live in darkness. Yes, I live in darkness. You can't see the light. Yes, I can't see the light. You are blind. Yes, I am blind. And so the ego is just like, what am I dealing with here? I don't understand. I don't understand. I don't understand. Yeah, the ego doesn't understand truth at all, does it? Never will. You will never be liked. Yes, I will never be liked. So you have this, you know, sunny, happy disposition as you're agreeing with everything the ego is saying. It says, you are super depressed. Yes, I'm super depressed. You're in absolute despair. Yes, I'm in absolute despair. You feel suicidal. Yes, I feel suicidal. You're out of control. Yes, I'm out of control. You're a menace. Yes, I'm a menace. You can't control yourself. Yes, I can't control myself. You're a lowlife. Yes, I'm a lowlife. You have no status. Yes, I have no status. We're going to forget all about you. Yes, you're going to forget all about me. It'd be better if you were never born. Yes, it would be better if I was never born. It was a mistake for you to be born. Yes, it was a mistake for me to be born. You should die. Yes, I should die. You are completely worthless. Yes, I am completely worthless. You're a perfect example of what not to be. Yes, I'm a perfect example of what not to be. Yeah, so the ego is scratching his head, saying, wow. What do we do? What do I do? I seem to be losing here, you know. You're a total loser. Yes, I'm a total loser. So this baffles the ego. Baffles. You're trying to upset me. Yes, I'm trying to upset you. You're trying to make me angry. Yes, I'm trying to make you angry. Well, you're terrible. Yes, I'm terrible. That's not right. Yes, that's not right. Stop doing it. Yes, stop doing it. But the ego says, but wait a minute, you're not using judgment. Yes, I'm not using judgment. But I want you to use judgment. Yes, you want me to use judgment. No, you're judging a lot. Yes, I'm judging a lot. You love judgment. Yes, I love judgment. But you just said, you're not judging. Yes, I'm not judging. But you love judgment. Yes, I love judgment. And the ego says, the only way is to experience it for yourself, and you'll be astonished. You'll be astonished. Just come away and say, wait, 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 wait. All my life I've been living in fear of the ego and what it could say to me. So now I'm embracing that and say whatever you can, the worst stuff possible. Let me think of the worst stuff possible I could ever be said to me and embrace it and say, it's wonderful. Yes, agree with it. Agree, agree, agree. You're absolute scum. Yes, I'm absolute scum. You should be ashamed of yourself. Yes, I should be ashamed of myself. You're hurting everyone. Yes, I'm hurting everyone. You'll never amount to anything. Yes, I'll never amount to anything. You're lazy. Yes, I'm lazy. You don't even try. Yes, I don't even try. You're a moron. Yes, I'm a moron. You're a psychopath. Yes, I'm a psychopath. And the ego says, well, that should have got them. That should have got them. You know, wait, no, nothing. The ego says, you should be burnt at the stake. Yes, I should be burnt at the stake. Society would be better off without you. Yes, society would be better off without me. You're a fake. Yes, I'm a fake. So all the stuff the ego, this is the ego's attitude. It will accuse you of anything just to try to induce you into judgment. Okay, that's why we live in fear of the ego. We know the ego is vicious, don't we? We all know the ego is vicious. And we all live in fear of the ego. We really do. This is why everybody's so defensive. And you see people, you realize, you know, they're like, they live in fear. Even people who pretend not to be, sometimes you'll catch their eye and you'll realize, they're living in fear. They're putting up a pretending like everybody likes me. I'm so popular. I'm great. They're terrified, you know. But when we embrace this and do this practice, you know, it seems very, very probable that we're doing the practice that Jesus has advised for. It's a very profound practice. Now, this is not the type of practice that Jesus mentions in A Course in Miracles. What he focuses on is positive affirmations. And I believe that positive affirmations are necessary initially. We don't have the strength yet to turn the tables on the ego like this and let the ego give us its best shot and just agree, 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 agree. You know, the ego says, you should be shot by a firing squad. Yes, I should be shot by a firing squad. You should be thrown in prison and tortured. Yes, I should be thrown in prison and tortured. And every agreement is exactly the same as every other agreement. And the ego says, you're a wonderful person. Yes, I'm a wonderful person. Uh-oh. What's this for? Okay. So what the ego does, it tries to trick us. It builds us up. And then tries to tear us down what is built up. And we're frightened of that. So the ego says, you're a wonderful person. Say, yes, I'm a wonderful person. You're quite extraordinary. Yes, I'm quite extraordinary. You know, you're very special. Yes, I'm very special. You're magnificent. Yes, I'm magnificent. You really know how to do the right thing. Yes, I really know how to do the right thing. You did the wrong thing there. Yes, I did the wrong thing there. Well, That's not very special. Yes, that's not very special. Well, maybe you're not extraordinary. Yes, maybe I'm not extraordinary. You're actually kind of dumb. Yes, I'm actually kind of dumb. Oh, but you're saved. Yes, I'm saved. Oh, now you're damned. Yes, now I'm damned. You're a beautiful child of God. Yes, I'm a beautiful child of God. God hates you. Yes, God hates me. And so the ego uses the positive, and we buy into the ego's positive, then we live in fear of its judgment of the ego, okay, the negative. So you can practice the positives and the negatives, both, okay? That's important. Not just the negatives. Work in the positives, too. And that gets a little trickier, right? Because you think, well, I don't want to lose that positive judgment the ego has on me. My God, the ego thinks I'm wonderful. The ego says, wow, you really understand Scripture well. Yes, I really understand Scripture well. The ego says, yeah, but you're very wrong about this. Yes, I'm very wrong about this. You don't make any mistakes. Yes, I don't make any mistakes. Oh, you made a terrible mistake there. Yes, I made a terrible mistake there. See, just non-dual, just peaceful, centered. Okay? And one way of putting this is saying, I am whatever you think of me. I am whatever you think of me. Whatever you say about me, it's all equally good for me. I agree with everything you say. Whatever you say, I agree with. It's all good. But this is actually a very advanced practice. And we can do this practice. We absolutely can do that, and we need to do it because the mind of the flesh is on this extreme ego trip right now. Arrogance is on this extreme ego trip in the world right now. The world is ego tripping like it's never ego tripped before right now. And it's both humorous and a little in unsettling at the same time. The more you can evaporate this fear, the more humorous it becomes. So it's like, okay, you're just ego tripping. Yes, I'm just ego tripping. Well, you don't have any humor. Yes, you don't have a sense of humor. Yes, I don't have a sense of humor. You're just a robot. Yes, I'm just a robot. You're easily controlled. Yes, I'm easily controlled. You're a magnificent free spirit. Yes, I'm a magnificent free spirit. You're easily controlled. Yes, I'm easily controlled. You're absolutely free. Yes, I'm absolutely free. You don't know what freedom is. Yes, I don't know what freedom is. See, the ego will try to jerk you around like this, positive and then negative, positive, negative, like this. And by this practice, we smooth it all out like this. And we lose the fear of what any the ego can say about us at all. It doesn't matter, positive or negative, we don't buy into any of it. Because I am, see. I am. You are so kind. Yes, I am so kind. If you do this for me, you'll be so kind. Yes, if I do this for you, I'll be so kind. Well, you just agree with me. Yes, I agree with you. So you agree that Jesus was flesh. Yes, I agree with Jesus was flesh. So you agree that God is a flesh person. Yes, I agree that God is a flesh person. But you said God is a spirit. Yes, I said that God is a spirit. So you think God is a spirit. Yes, I think that God is a spirit. But you just said God is flesh. Yes, I just said that God is flesh. So you don't allow yourself to get pulled into anything. You just, whatever is said, you just agree. Yes, I agree. I agree. What are you, just a computer program? Yes, I'm just a are you just a computer program? Yes, I'm just a computer program. So you have no mind of your own? Yes, I have no mind of my own. Well, you're separate from God. Yes, I'm separate from God. Well, this is terrible. Yes, this is terrible. And on and on and on, right? It's practicing. Now, it does produce some shakeup. There's no question. If you keep doing it, now I've seemed to be, able to do this very well because of such a long history of practice and effort in many different ways. But I can understand you may feel like some shaking from this, like, wow, this is really intense. This is amazing. So remember, full stop in the wow, of course, and remind yourself of this, that you're not failing. This is really intense practice. You're bringing shame to this family. Yes, I'm bringing shame to this family. Your ancestors are despise you. Yes, my ancestors despise me. All your relatives think that you're a disgrace. Yes, all my relatives think that I'm a disgrace. You are very disgraceful. Yes, I am very disgraceful. You're trying to pull everyone down. Yes, I'm trying to pull everyone down. You're trying to keep people from advancing. Yes, I'm trying to keep people from advancing. You're an anti-human. Yes, I'm anti-human. You're antisocial. Yes, I'm antisocial. You don't know what you're talking about. Yes, I don't know what I'm talking about. Now, as we've said, the key about an enlightened being is their presence, their attitude, their presence. They have a presence about them. It's this super stable, calm, stable presence which the ego cannot understand. The ego says, "What quality do they have? You're great. You're really wonderful, aren't you? Yes, I'm really wonderful. But you're very mysterious. Yes, I'm very mysterious. You're very non-responsive. Yes, I'm very non-responsive. You speak in riddles. Yes, I speak in riddles. You aren't really explaining anything. Yes, I'm not really explaining anything. You don't know how to teach. Yes, I don't know how to teach. You should just give up. Yes, I should just give up. And so, you see, the ego goes to induce judgment from the teacher, and the teacher has realized, perfect non-judgment, forgiven itself for this dream of arrogance, and so they cannot uproot the teacher, the guru, cannot uproot them, cannot induce judgment into them in this way, within their mind. You see, so they remain calm and blissful and peaceful, and it's this that you experience, just experience this. And you say, huh, looks like the ego's lost its grip on this one. How did that happen? You really made a great deal, huh? Yes, I really made a great deal. You really found a great compromise, huh? Yes, I really found a great compromise. You really trust in the goddess, don't you? Yes, I really trust in the goddess. You really found the right compromise, didn't you? Yes, I really found the right compromise. See, and you stay poisoned all this because it's trying to put words in your mouth. So the ego's an expert at putting words in your mouth. But again, whatever, just agree. Yes, whatever, all the lies, whatever the ego's saying, the misconstructions are fine. Just agree, 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 agree. Agree, 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 agree. So, I understand what your teachings are. Yes, you understand what my teachings are. You're teaching duality. Yes, I'm teaching duality. So you're a dualistic goddess worshiper. Yes, I'm a dualistic goddess worshiper. So that's what everybody should be attracted to. Yes, that's what everybody should be attracted to. So you think the whole world should forsake G the whole world should forsake Jesus. Yes, the whole world should forsake Jesus. And see, now the ego, what is this trying to do? Induce judgment, which would uproot you from guru-ness, okay, holiness, sacredness, which is non-judgment of reality. God does not judge all our entries into how we think time is going to be. Hey, God, you know, this is what I think time is going to be. It's going to be really wonderful and great. You know, don't you agree? When, you know, our God, I think time is going to be horrible. It's going to be like this. Don't you agree? God never pays any attention to all these exhibits that we have. We think that, you know, there's entries. Here, God, entry to a judging contest. No judgment from God. God pays no, oblivious to it, completely oblivious to it. So again, the teacher often will agree with anything, whatever anyone says. Sure, you say that, fine. That's, yes, whatever you say, I agree with. Whatever you say, I agree with. You know, everybody should be going out and doing good works. Yes, everybody should be going out and doing good works. Everybody is saved through works, not grace. Yes, everybody is saved through works, not grace. You don't believe in grace. Yes, I don't believe in grace. You don't believe in the Holy Spirit. Yes, I don't believe in the Holy Spirit. You believe in mental confusion. Yes, I believe in mental confusion. You're teaching mental confusion. Yes, I'm teaching mental confusion. You're teaching wrong teachings. Yes, I'm teaching wrong teachings. Of course, all the while, bliss, 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 bliss. You see? Yeah, so this is one of the great secrets. The great teachers, whatever anyone says about them, they agree, yes, 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 whatever. It's all the same to me, wonderful. It's all yes, it's all wonderful. Yes to everything. Yes, I agree with everything. You're a great teacher. Yes, I'm a great teacher. You're a terrible teacher. Yes, I'm a terrible teacher. Equal agreement, you see. Just equal, sameness, 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 sameness. All judgment is equally flat, zero. But put it into this format of positive, smiling, gracious. Yes, yes, I agree. No matter what they say, you don't believe in grace, do you? You don't believe in grace. Yes, I don't believe in grace. You don't believe in the Holy Spirit at all. Yes, I don't believe in the Holy Spirit at all. See, no matter what they say, keep agreeing. You don't believe in God. Yes, I don't believe in God. You're an atheist. Yes, I'm an atheist. You're an agnostic. Yes, I'm an agnostic. You're a secular materialist. Yes, I'm a secular materialist. You're a religious fanatic. Yes, I'm a religious fanatic. You're a business person. Yes, I'm a business person. You're only in it for the money. Yes, I'm only in it for the money. You're a scoundrel. Yes, I'm a scoundrel. You're beloved of God. Yes, I'm beloved of God. God hates you. Yes, God hates me. You see that? With this equanimity, no matter how the ego presents itself, just agree equally, with no emotion, except this is positive, yes, 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 I agree. I'm not having like any emotions at all when I'm hearing these accusations. You're a false prophet. Yes, I'm a false prophet. You're the Antichrist. Yes, I'm the Antichrist. You are the Christ. Yes, I'm the Christ. You're God's messenger. Yes, I'm God's messenger. You're the devil's messenger. Yes, I'm the devil's messenger. You're teaching false doctrine. Yes, I'm teaching false doctrine. Oh, you're teaching the truth. Yes, I'm teaching the truth. You're teaching confusion. Yes, I'm teaching confusion. You're teaching clarity. Yes, I'm teaching clarity. Nobody can understand you. Yes, nobody can understand me. This is all nonsense. Yes, this is all nonsense. This is very profound. Yes, this is very profound. Well, you're a total madman. Yes, I'm a total madman. You're very dangerous. Yes, I'm very dangerous. You're so helpful. Yes, I'm so helpful. You're so insightful. Yes, I'm so insightful. So, you're simply just agreeing with what's ever said, whatever is labels put on you, just agree. Just agree with what, whatever concept, whatever idea, whatever label it is, just agree with the label, yeah. You're really out of date. Yes, I'm really out of date. You're just, you're old-fashioned. Yes, I'm old-fashioned. You're really hip. Yes, I'm really hip. You're really connecting with everybody. Yes, I'm really connecting with everybody. You're just not connecting with anyone. Yes, I'm just not connecting with anyone. Jesus is laughing at you. Yes, Jesus is laughing at me. Jesus loves you. Yes, Jesus loves me. Jesus thinks you're a joke. Yes, Jesus thinks I'm a joke. Jesus condemns you. Yes, Jesus condemns me. Jesus saves, has saved you. Yes, Jesus has saved me. You're with God. Yes, I'm with God. You're alienated from God. Yes, I'm alienated from God. All right. So, you get the picture, and you can keep going and going and going as we have been doing here. And you will find it a most fascinating exercise. Just, you can hardly believe how many condemnations you can make of yourself and how you try to use this dualistic, build yourself up to tear yourself down, build up, tear down, build up, tear down. And you know, as soon as you buy into the good, you start protecting it from the accusations, and then you think, oh wait a minute, I believe I'm good, but then maybe I did something that's not so good, you know, like, oh shoot, I'm, you know, guilty, I'm being judged. And say, yes, I'm good. And the ego says, no, you're not any good. Yes, I'm not any good. You should feel guilty. Yes, I should feel guilty. You should be ruined. Yes, I should be ruined. You're ruining everybody. Yes, I'm ruining everybody. You have no shame. Yes, I have no shame. You're greedy. Yes, I'm greedy. You're a terrible sinner. Yes, I'm a terrible sinner. You're a wonderful humanitarian. Yes, I'm a wonderful humanitarian. You truly know how to reach people. Yes, I truly know how to reach people. You're really out of touch. Yes, I'm really out of touch. See, same, 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 positive, negative, positive, negative, all the same, 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 just agree with it, agree with it, agree with it. Have exactly the same reaction as a, just agreement with no matter what is said. Practice, 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 practice this. You will astonish yourself. You will truly be astonished at this, that you didn't realize you had the capacity to practice in this way. The ego is terrified of this, you see. That's why it never tells you this. That's why it doesn't want to interpret what Jesus said properly, does it? It wants to misinterpret it. And there's another one to practice. You're misinterpreting everything. Yes, I'm misinterpreting everything. Or, oh, you've really got this right, haven't you? Yes, I've really got this right. Oh, you're mistaken about this. Yes, I'm mistaken about this. You're the only one who can ever get this right. Yes, I'm the only one who can ever get this right. You're an egomaniac. Yes, I'm an egomaniac. You're very divisive. Yes, I'm very divisive. You are the true Savior. Yes, I am the true Savior. You are the false Savior. Yes, I am the false Savior. Okay. where are we going here? Let me see. There you go. Agree with your adversary quickly. So you see how quickly we're agreeing with it here. You don't think about it. Say, now, wait a minute. The ego's saying I'm good. You know, am I really good? No, just agree. Yes, I am good. And the ego says, you're not really good. Yes, I'm not really good. You're double-minded. Yes, I'm double-minded. You're disassociating. Yes, I'm disassociating. You have severe mental illness. Yes, I have severe mental illness. Well, you're proving that you do. Yes, I'm proving that I do. So you agree that you're proving. Yes, I agree that I'm proving. So you have condemned yourself. Yes, I have condemned myself. You have found the way to freedom. Yes, I have found the way to freedom. You're going down into a terrible trap. Yes, I'm going down into a terrible trap. Same reaction to no matter what is said, positive or negative. So, most extraordinary. Yes, this is most extraordinary. this is nothing extraordinary. Yes, this is nothing extraordinary. This is old hat. Yes, this is old hat. Everybody already knows this. Yes, everybody already knows this. Nothing to see here. Yes, nothing to see here. Time to move along. Yes, time to move along. Nothing profound. Yes, nothing profound. No need to practice this. Yes, no need to practice this. This practice really isn't going to help. Yes, this practice isn't really going to help. You should only do a little bit of this. Yes, you should only do a little bit of this. You should do a lot of this. Yes, you should do a lot of this. This isn't very clear. Yes, this isn't very clear. So you need to search, keep searching, see if you can find something that bothers you. You know, keep looking. And practice this, keep practicing it. Just no matter what's said, just agree, keep practicing this. And again, you will astonish yourself. You think, oh, I'm supposed to get upset at this. Yes, I'm supposed to get upset at this. Or you are upset at this. Yes, I am upset with this. You're very upset with this. Yes, I am very upset with this. You're very angry. Yes, I'm very angry. You're very intolerant. Yes, I'm very intolerant. You're very easily disturbed. Yes, I'm very easily disturbed. You're a great, peaceful, blissful guru. Yes, I'm a great, peaceful, blissful guru. You're a very insecure person. Yes, I'm a very insecure person. You are spirit. Yes, I am spirit. You're flesh. Yes, I'm flesh. You're both spirit and flesh. Yes, I am both spirit and flesh. You're nothing. Yes, I am nothing. You're everything. Yes, I am everything. You're confusion. Yes, I am confusion. You're time. Yes, I'm time. You believe in time. Yes, I believe in time. You fear time. Yes, I fear time. You're not prepared for time. Yes, I'm not prepared for time. You need to prepare for time. Yes, I need to prepare for time. You're not doing enough. Yes, I'm not doing enough. You need to follow my advice. Yes, I need to follow your advice. My advice is to stop this practice. Yes, your advice is to stop this practice. You should stop this practice. Yes, I should stop this practice. You're stopping this practice right now. Yes, I'm stopping this practice right now. You're still practicing. Yes, I'm still practicing. You're not listening to me. Yes, I'm not listening to you. You're very selfish. Yes, I'm very selfish. If you listen to me, you'd be selfless. Yes, if I listened to you, I would be selfless. You will do everything I say. Yes, I will do everything you say. You will stop agreeing with me. Yes, I will stop agreeing with you. You will stop agreeing with me right now. Yes, I will stop agreeing with you right now. The moon is made of cheese. Yes, the moon is made of cheese. You will die in 3 seconds. Yes, I will die in 3 seconds. You won't make it through the night. Yes, I won't make it through the night. Death is coming to get you. Yes, death is coming to get me. Okay, so this gets into a little greater intensity. So, you know, it's like, like, see, the ego's trying to scare you in this way. You are eternal life. Yes, I am eternal life. You're going to die in an accident. Yes, I'm going to die in an accident. You cannot avoid your fate. Yes, I cannot avoid my fate. You have a terrible fate. Yes, I have a terrible fate. You have a wonderful future. Yes, I have a wonderful future. You have a great destiny. Yes, I have a great destiny. You're failing to meet your destiny, your potential. You're failing to meet your potential. Yes, I'm failing to meet my potential. You're avoiding love. Yes, I'm avoiding love. You need to embrace love. Yes, I need to embrace love. You need to meet special people. Yes, I need to meet special people. You need to be terminated. Yes, I need to be terminated. You're impossible. Yes, I'm impossible. Okay, so the ego, you see, it's just like, I've, you know, got to get some judgment going here. But now, I've never, ever heard anyone practice this way in all of my investigations throughout history of practice and religious practices and beliefs. I've never, ever, ever come across anything like this, really. But so it's tough to break the ice, you know, on this. But like I said, I've done it 3 times now. It's getting easier and easier and easier and easier and easier. And the key is to just agree instantly, right away. Don't give it any thought. The ego say, you don't know what you're doing. Yes, I don't know what I'm doing. And don't start thinking, do I know what I'm doing? No, you just stay poised with no thought, waiting for the next, whatever the ego says next. Just waiting to agree with it, that's all. Just waiting to agree. You're just wasting your time. Yes, I'm just wasting my time. This practice doesn't help at all. Yes, this practice doesn't help at all. You'll be better off not doing this practice. Yes, I'd be better off not doing this practice. This practice is going to bring instant enlightenment. Yes, this practice is going to bring instant enlightenment. This practice is going to cause mental insanity. Yes, this practice is going to cause mental insanity. This practice should be banned. Yes, this practice should be banned. This practice should be taught to everyone. Yes, this practice should be taught to everyone. This practice is silly. Yes, this practice is silly. You will be condemned for this practice. Yes, I will be condemned for this practice. You will be exalted for this practice. Yes, I will be exalted for this practice. You are helping so many. You will help so many. Yes, I will help so many. You're self-deluded, thinking you can help anyone. Yes, I'm self-deluded, thinking I can help anyone. You're running out of time. Yes, I'm running out of time. Nobody cares. Yes, nobody cares. This is just ridiculous. Yes, this is just ridiculous. This is a great breakthrough. Yes, this is a great breakthrough. Ah, this is no big deal. Yes, this is no big deal. Whatever. Yes, whatever. This is very hard to understand. Yes, this is very hard to understand. This is very discriminatory. Yes, this is very discriminatory. You like to discriminate. Yes, I like to discriminate. You're not being inclusive. Yes, I'm not being inclusive. You're making it too difficult for people. Yes, I'm making it too difficult for people. You should be more inclusive. Yes, I should be more inclusive. You should change the practice. Yes, I should change the practice. You are going to change the practice. Yes, I am going to change the practice. You are now advocating something different. Yes, I am now advocating something different. You are being very confusing. Yes, I am being very, very confusing. You don't keep your word. Yes, I don't keep my word. You're not serious. Yes, I'm not serious. You must be some kind of wacko. Yes, I must be some kind of wacko. Wow, you're some kind of tinfoil maniac. Yes, I'm some kind of tinfoil maniac. Tinfoil hat. You must be some weird ET. Yes, I must be some weird ET. You must be some new ager. Yes, I must be some new ager. You must be some kind of Bible fanatic. Yes, I must be some kind of Bible fanatic. You're trying to stir up trouble. Yes, I'm trying to stir up trouble. Why can't you be normal? Yes, why can't I be normal? This is extremely abnormal. Yes, this is extremely abnormal. This can't be right. Yes, this can't be right. You're off your rocker. Yes, I'm off my rocker. Of course, if you want more things to say, the internet's full of them, right? And the forums, discussions, comments, everybody, people are, you know, hurling whatever they think they can find a stick, you know, to pull someone else into judgment. Say, you're some kind of wingnut, huh? Yes, I'm some kind of wingnut. You're some sort of conspiracy theorist. Yes, I'm some kind of conspiracy theorist. Oh, you must be some kind of truther. Yes, I must be some kind of truther. Oh, you must be some kind of birther. Yes, I must be some kind of birther. You don't believe in climate change. Yes, I don't believe in climate change. Oh, you're one of those climate change fanatics. Yes, I'm one of those climate change fanatics. You believe in those, all those, like the government's out to get you. Yes, I believe the government's out to get me. You believe in tearing the country apart. Yes, I believe in tearing the country apart. Oh, you're some kind of patriot. Yes, I'm some kind of patriot. Oh, you're some kind of knee-jerk liberal. Yes, I'm some kind of knee-jerk liberal. Oh, you're some kind of reactionary conservative. Yes, I'm some kind of reactionary conservative. You support the New World Agenda. Yes, I support the New World Agenda. You're trying to prevent progress. Yes, I'm trying to prevent progress. You love the world culture. Yes, I love the world culture. You hate the world culture. Yes, I hate the world culture. You think that everybody who has a smartphone is really brilliant. Yes, I think that everyone who has a smartphone is really brilliant. You think that everyone has a smartphone is an idiot. Yes, I think that everyone who has a smartphone is an idiot. You hate technology. Yes, I hate technology. You love technology. Yes, I love technology. You support gay marriage. Yes, I support gay marriage. You don't support gay marriage. Yes, I don't support gay marriage. You agree with abortion. Yes, I agree with abortion. You're anti-abortion. Yes, I'm anti-abortion. Watching television is, you think watching television is good for you. Yes, I think watching television is good for you. You think watching television is bad for you. Yes, I think watching television is bad for you. So again, no matter what the ego puts into your mouth, the words that put them out, just agree, 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 agree. No matter what they say, you see, whatever, you can just go on and on and on and practice all the time. Just whatever comes to your mind, just agree, 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 and then try to take opposite sides of it and agree on the opposite sides of it, right? You're a really hardcore communist. Yes, I'm a really hardcore communist. You're an extreme capitalistic pig. Yes, I'm an extreme capitalistic pig. You're a greedy, unconscionable one percenter. Yes, I'm a greedy, unconscionable one percenter. You're a radical revolutionary. Yes, I'm a radical revolutionary. You're a disgusting hippie. Yes, I'm a disgusting hippie. You're a bloated, greedy fat cat. Yes, I'm a bloated, greedy fat cat. You believe in a one-world bureaucracy. Yes, I believe in a one-world bureaucracy. You believe in anarchy. Yes, I believe in anarchy. You believe in totalitarian control. Yes, I believe in totalitarian control. You believe in free love. Yes, I believe in free love. You believe in celibacy. Yes, I believe in celibacy. You believe in hedonism. You love hedonism. Yes, I love hedonism. You teach extreme self-discipline. Yes, I teach extreme self-discipline. You advocate a riotous lifestyle. Yes, I advocate a riotous lifestyle. You advocate severe restrictions. Yes, I advocate severe restrictions. You want to do away with all restrictions? Yes, I want to do away with all restrictions. You're extremely biased. Yes, I'm extremely biased. You're extraordinarily fair. Yes, I'm extraordinarily fair. You can't practice like this. Yes, I can't practice like this. This is just getting nowhere. Yes, this is just getting nowhere. You're a time worshipper. Yes, I'm a time worshipper. You don't believe in time? Yes, I don't believe in time. You're just wishful thinking. Yes, I'm just wishful thinking. You're just imagining all this. Yes, I'm just imagining all this. If you don't prepare for time, you're going to be annihilated. Yes, if I don't prepare for time, I'm going to be annihilated. There isn't any time. Yes, there isn't any time. There is time. Yes, there is time. There isn't time. Yes, there isn't time. You're contradicting yourself. Yes, I'm contradicting myself. You're trying to please truth and lies. Yes, I'm trying to please truth and lies. You can't be trusted. Yes, I can't be trusted. This is really very helpful. Yes, this is really very helpful. I'm not getting any help at all. Yes, I'm not getting any help at all. So, my mind is just staying stable, steady. None of this is, you know, getting to me or bothering me. So, prove to yourself you can do this. It's quite something. This is all a waste of time. Yes, this is all a waste of time. What utter rubbish this is. Yes, what utter rubbish this is. This is something only a monkey would do. Yes, this is something only a monkey would do. Only an idiot could believe in this. Yes, only an idiot could believe in this. You are one disturbed freak. Yes, I am one disturbed freak. You are very pitiful. Yes, I am very pitiful. You're really sad to see. Yes, it's really sad to see. You got no mind of your own. Yes, I have no mind of my own. This just proves that you're an idiot. Yes, this just proves that I'm an idiot. If you agree with me one more time, this will just prove that you're a mental case. Yes, if I agree with you one more time, it will prove that I'm a mental case. If you agree one more time, it will prove that you're false. This is a false teaching. Yes, if I agree with you one more time, this will prove that it's a false teaching. So you just proved it's a false teaching. Yes, I just proved it's a false teaching. Well, you must be a false teacher. Yes, I must be a false teacher. Well, then you must stop teaching. Yes, I must stop teaching. You're crazy. Yes, I'm crazy. This is scary. Yes, this is scary. I'm getting spooked. Yes, I'm getting spooked. I can't say anything. You won't agree with. Yes, I can't say anything. I won't agree with. You can't say anything I won't agree with. You disagree with me. Yes, I disagree with you. You just disagree with me. Yes, I just disagree with you. So you disagree with me in every way. Yes, so I disagree with you in every way. You're an idiot. Yes, I'm an idiot. You just agree with me. Yes, I just agree with you. That's how it goes. So you heard it here first. And you can really put yourself through this, a workout like this. Now, so we have that practice, and there's also the practice of liberated in the now. When you want to shift practices, you don't have to be pinned just to one practice. I'm finding there's a number of practices that you can shift them. We can shift among, light, liberated in the now. Speak to the light. All the light we see here, light. I just liberated you into the now. Light liberated into the now. You are the liberator. Okay, so you say concrete, liberated in the now. Stone, liberated in the now. Soil, liberated in the now. Dust, liberated in the now. Water, liberated in the now. Seeds, liberated in the now. Vegetation, liberated in the now. Plastic, liberated in the now. Glass, liberated in the now. Electricity, liberated in the now. Electromagnetism, liberated in the now. So go about liberating your universe. Go about liberating it. Be the liberator of your universe. Absolutely. You absolutely have the power to do that. And as to has this having any effects? Besides that much, I just fly in my mouth. I guess it didn't. I had a couple of interesting situations arise recently where, see, I feel that as we, the more we practice on this liberation, the more miracles will start creeping into our lives and stuff will be softening up. Our experiences start softening up because we're liberating everything. We're liberating our universe. Okay, into the now, which is, light. It's all light, isn't it? It's all just light. It's undefined light, actually. Really, light can never be defined. Nothing can ever define reality, freedom. And so whatever you see, we think, oh, this is something. Liberated in the now. You are now liberated into the now. Metal, liberated into the now. Rubber, liberated into the now. Air, liberated into the now. Sickness, liberated into the now. Chemistry, liberated into the now. Minerals, liberated into the now. Structure, liberated into the now. Events, liberated into the now. Injury, liberated into the now. Accidents, liberated into the now. Scarcity, liberated into the now. Money, liberated into the now. Position, liberated into the now. Thought, liberated into the now. So, here's an interesting little story that just happened. A couple of things just happened. I sort of ran through a gamut of troubles that seemed to arise, and the troubles resolved themselves in a quite amazing way, in a different way they thought. I lost a key that it somehow it came out of my pocket. There's no duplicate, and it's very important. I had to find that key. I couldn't find it anywhere. It was amazing, I said. And then I thought, what must have happened? I said, I must have pulled my keychain out of my pocket, and I must have hooked this key and somehow pulled it out of my pocket somewhere. But I said, wow, I've been pulling my keychain out all over town. You know, what do I do? So I went back and retraced my steps, where I might have gone, where I might have gone. And finally, it wasn't there, wasn't there, wasn't there. And I thought, you know what? Why don't you just leave it somewhere on the floor of the office? Just have the key be on the floor of the office for me. I say, key liberated in the now. Key metal liberated in the now. Form liberated in the now. And so finally, the last place I went was checking the office, and I said, if I don't find it here, I'm really in big trouble here, because we need this key desperately. And opened the office door, and there was the key lying on the floor right there for me. And I said, wow. That's great. It's absolutely amazing. Okay, now was it there all the time? Probably, but it was there. Now, then I looked at the tire of my truck, and I needed to do a long drive the next day, and there was this big shank of nasty metal in the truck tire like this. And I could see that the rubber on the tire was like sort of pushed up. I said, oh my gosh, I got something really nasty in my tire. And I said, you know, tire, liberated in the now. Rubber, liberated in the now. Metal, liberated in the now. You know, troubles, liberated in the now. And so I brought in the tire place, and I said, you know, you need to fix this. And they say, okay. And I said, well, maybe it's not all the way, maybe it didn't puncture. You know, maybe it's a nasty looking piece of metal, but maybe it didn't puncture. And they say, well, it's possible, you know, but oftentimes we pull it out and it's just blocking the air, and it deflates, you know. So later on, I called them up and they said, you know what, we can't find any leak anywhere. It's absolutely not having any problem whatsoever with any leak. It didn't go through. I said, wow, that's great. Yeah. So the trouble was softened up. So what the Holy Spirit told me is actually, as you liberate, keep working on liberating everything in the now, your life will start softening up. Very, you know, gradually, bit by bit by bit. It's not necessarily something super dramatic, but something else, something like that, that in the past, you know, would have been like a big problem for you. Now it just kind of resolves like, oh, it looked like it might be a problem, but it's not. It's not. Oh, you looks like you lost your key, but oh, you didn't. You found it. Looks like your tire was going to be severely punctured. Oh, but it's not. Various situations like that. As you liberate everything in your universe into the now, you give it permission that you are now liberated. You have my full permission. Sky, liberated in the now. Clouds, liberated in the now. difficulty, liberated in the now. Vegetation, liberated in the now. Wood, liberated in the now. Fruit, liberated in the now. Food, liberated in the now. Textiles, liberated in the now. Electricity, liberated in the now. Gasoline, liberated in the now. Gasoline, liberated in the now. Now, I had this situation recently where I have a truck that I don't use very often, and the battery goes dead. So I said, I got to charge this truck up. So I turned it on. I turned the engine on, and then I went and taped. Well, I forgot that I had turned the truck engine on. I turned it on in the afternoon, late afternoon, maybe 6 o'clock, 7 o'clock or something. So I went to sleep, and I woke up in the morning, and I realized, you know, oh my gosh, I forgot to turn the truck off. I said, oh, shoot, this is completely out of gas then. And and then I thought, oh my gosh, I prayed gasoline, somehow replenish yourself so, you know, you don't run out of gas. The truck was on, like, running for like 14 hours, something like that, or more, about, let's say 14 hours straight. Now, what it turns out was, the truck was still running in the morning. It didn't run out of gas. I said, that's impossible. I thought, wow, that's just astonishing. How, you know, okay. So, I said, well, wow, it must be almost out of gas. Well, I found out that the truck still had, like, over a half a tank still left. And the truck tank takes like 16 gallons or something. So it's like, in 14 hours, the truck only burned 8 gallons of gas. I said, wow, this is really weird. Someone coming. I don't know what's going on. Sounds are being made. I said, how is that possible? Now, I guess it's theoretically possible. I mean, I guess if a vehicle is idling, it doesn't use hardly any gas. I don't know, but 14 hours and only using like 8 gallons. So I found this to be very, quite interesting, I still don't know what to make of it, but I was just saying, gasoline liberated in the now. Gasoline liberated in the now. Maybe if we want to increase our gas mileage in the world, liberate gasoline into the now. You see? Pollution, liberated in the now. Pollution, liberated in the now. Hazardous waste, liberated in the now. Hazardous waste, liberated in the now. Drought, liberated in the now. Famine, liberated in the now. Cancer, liberated in the now. See, love your enemy. Do good to those who persecute you. Pray for those who hate you. Right? Cancer, liberated in the now. Dementia, liberated in the now. Death, liberated in the now. Environmental damage, liberated in the now. Climate change, liberated in the now. Earthquakes, liberated in the now. Tornadoes, liberated in the now. Hurricanes, cyclones, liberated in the now. Plagues, liberated in the now. liberated in the now. Tsunamis, liberated in the now. Ocean, liberated in the now. Ice, liberated in the now. Creatures, liberated in the now. Conflict, liberated in the now. Weapons, liberated in the now. Crime, liberated in the now. Brick, liberated in the now. Tile, liberated in the now. Wallpaper, liberated in the now. Appliances, liberated in the now. Light bulbs, liberated in the now. So whatever you see, say liberated. Okay, just you grant it, it's absolute, unconditional, undefined freedom. Unconditional freedom to everything. Liberate in the now. Computers, liberated in the now. Smartphones, liberated in the now. Tablets, liberated in the now. Gaming consoles, liberated in the now. Boredom, liberated in the now. Drugs, liberated in the now. Illnesses, liberated in the now. Afflictions, liberated in the now. So, as we keep working at this, the Holy Spirit suggested, look to see, maybe everything will start easing up, just like that piece of metal, somehow it didn't puncture the tire. It's quite odd, actually, though. It went sideways, sort of. Say, oh, I thought it was a bad problem. It's not. It's not. So we may be able to ease everything up on us. Everything up on us. Everything eased up upon us. And in fact, we could all do this. Disease, liberated in the now. Parasites, liberated in the now. Depletion, liberated in the now. Oil, liberated in the now. Batteries, liberated in the now. Gadgets, liberated in the now. Landscape, liberated in the now. Asphalt, liberated in the now. Paint, liberated in the now. Machinery, liberated in the now. Material goods, liberated in the now. televisions liberated in the now, microwaves liberated in the now. Organisms liberated in the now. Rain liberated in the now. Rain liberated in the now. Mountains liberated in the now. So, this is another very advanced practice that we can use. Nothing's stopping us from doing this, is it? Wherever we are, wherever it surrounds us, we can liberate it. We can say, hey, you know, palm tree liberated in the now. All palm trees liberated in the now. All messes liberated in the now. All garbage liberated in the now. All garbage liberated in the now. All growth liberated in the now. All decay liberated in the now. All insects liberated in the now. You see a mosquito buzzing around. It's like, all mosquitoes liberated in the now. Give the light that's in the pretending to be in the form of this mosquito, give permission to be liberated in the now. All heat liberated in the now. All vibration liberated in the now. All stones liberated in the now. All pebbles liberated in the now. All debris liberated in the now. All space liberated in the now. All atmosphere liberated in the now. All flying things liberated in the now. Flying liberated in the now. Walking liberated in the now. Sitting liberated in the now. Lying down, liberated in the now. All lakes liberated in the now. All weeds liberated in the now. All vegetables liberated in the now. All produce liberated in the now. All food liberated in the now. All refrigerators liberated in the now. All refrigerators liberated in the now. Now we're told, Jesus tells us that every last thing that happens here, it happens because we are desiring it to happen, including, for instance, a refrigerator stopping. Or an air conditioning. Air conditioning liberated in the now. Air conditioning liberated in the now. Now, our air conditioning just broke. And the funny thing is, it just broke, stopped working, right on the day that it got to be 102 degrees, scorching, scorching hot. That's when it chose to stop working. I said, that's very interesting. It could have stopped working any other time at all. And instead, it picked that evening when it was like most needed. That's when it stopped working. I said, wow, that's not a coincidence. Very interesting. So maybe it's saying, hey, how about just temperature? Liberated in the now. Released in the now. Temperature released in the now. How about that? Try that. Temperature released in the now. Presence released in the now. Ambience released in the now. But temperature, atmospheric temperature, released in the now. comfort released in the now. Discomfort released in the now. And they say, well, we can't come out for like over a week. So you just have to live without the AC. That's a good time to practice then, isn't it? I did the same thing with the computer. I've had this string of things happen. That one after the other is very strange. First, computer crashes, and it looks like it's completely dead. There's no way to fix it. Try everything. And I said to computer, liberate it in the now. Computer, liberate it in the now. And I prayed on the computer. Computer, liberate it in the now. Well, somehow, by letting it repair itself all night long, it took all night. Somehow it managed to repair itself and it's working, which is quite a surprise. So we have that happen also. I thought, oh gosh, don't have any money to buy a computer. It's not working. Not this one, it was someone else's computer, but we needed to get it working. And so in many, 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 many subtle ways, if you keep releasing everything in the now, keep working at it, your experiencing may subtly, gradually soften up on you. Stuff seems like happening to you. It's like, oh, that's not nearly as bad. Now that dog I told you about, that dog that they were going to put to sleep, well, I saw that dog again today. Still living, still doing okay. And they were like, the owner's like, really, like, wow, yeah, she's okay. He's like, really, they're like, really surprised, you know. And I was with the dog. I said, dog, you know, illness released in the now, sickness released in the now, infirmity released in the now, troubles released in the now, discomfort released in the now, death released in the now. So I actually, you know, focused on the dog and released everything to the now. Dog's looking at me like, who knows what the dog is thinking or not thinking. Clouds released in the now. You can use liberated, released, whatever, you know, it just feels right that. Car released in the now. Car, truck released in the now. Decay released in the now. Breakage released in the now. Wear and tear released in the now. Wear and tear released in the now. Wear and tear released in the now. So this is an extremely interesting experiment here, which I'm undertaking, and you can too. You can too. And you can be like, you're like, you know, this is a spiritual astronaut, really, and you know try this out. And it may not be super, glaringly obvious, but it may be just little stuff that starts going right or less wrong for you, or you know, it's softened up somehow. Or you can say, like, weight gain released in the now. Weight gain released in the now. Anxiety released in the now. Anxiety released in the now. Improvidence released in the now. Improvidence released in the now. World released in the now. Universe released in the now. Actions released in the now. Reactions released in the now. Troubles released in the now. Upset released in the now. So, I'm seeing that the world could be, this dream, we could change it to a dream of preparing for time not to start. There is a way, it seems to be, there is a way. These two practices, these various practices here, in simply, you know, letting go of the ego, and also liberating our universe from this preparation, preparing us for time. We liberate it from that. Now it is preparing us for time not to start. Whereas the old universe is preparing us for time to start. So all this stuff was happening to us. We didn't want all this stuff happening. So I don't want that. I don't want that. I don't want that. Now as we're liberating all this, liberating it into the now, then our experiencing may become what we do want. See, gradually, imperceptibly, this is a possibility. Aging released. Released in the now. Aging released in the now. Aging released in the now. Actually give it permission. Give aging permission, for your full permission, to be released in the now. Wear and tear released in the now. Pain released in the now. Pain released in the now. So we could have a civilization, a culture, based on this type of practice right here. Irritation released in the now. Irritation released in the now. Disharmony released in the now. Disharmony released in the now. Circumstances released in the now. Situations released in the now. Homelessness released in the now. Homelessness released in the now. Addiction released in the now. Addiction released in the now. Suffering released in the now. Misunderstandings released in the now. Disagreements released in the now. Energy released in the now. Energy released in the now. Energy released in the now. Light released in the now. Light released in the now. Give the light permission to be released into the now, into this a dream of preparing for time not to start. A dream of preparing for time not to start. So we're doing this segue here with keeping continuity. So we're shifting into this dream of preparing for time not to start. Trauma released in the now. Trauma released in the now. Trauma released in the now. Healing released in the now. Healing released in the now. Food released in the now. Drink released in the now. Sustenance released in the now. Life released in the now. Awareness released in the now. Consciousness released in the now. Consciousness released in the now. instability released in the now. Shock released in the now. Isolation released in the now. Isolation released in the now. Process released in the now. Process released in the now. Predation. Predation, predatory. Predation released in the now. Attack released in the now. Uncertainty released in the now. So this is, we can practice this one quite a bit. And I've been doing this now for a week, actually, this particular one, strongly, for a week. Culture released in the now. Culture released in the now. Civilization liberated in the now. Civilization liberated in the now. Housing liberated in the now. Housing, landscape liberated in the now. Maintenance liberated in the now. Maintenance liberated in the now. So instead of complaining, liberate. Instead of complaining, liberate. Don't complain, liberate. Encroachment liberated in the now. Decimation liberated in the now. War liberated in the now. Mistrust liberated in the now. Lava liberated in the now. Dust liberated in the now. Pollen liberated in the now. Flowers liberated in the now. Plants liberated in the now. Medicines liberated in the now. Treatments liberated in the now. Therapy liberated in the now. Mind liberated in the now. Thought liberated in the now. Exertion liberated in the now. Fatigue liberated in the now. Paper products liberated in the now. Paper liberated in the now. Crystals liberated in the now. Gems, liberated in the now. Jewelry, liberated in the now. Sofas, liberated in the now. Carpets, liberated in the now. Dirt, liberated in the now. Livestock, liberated in the now. Questions, liberated in the now. Lighting, liberated in the now. Furniture, liberated in the now. Clocks, liberated in the now. Watches, liberated in the now. Entertainment, liberated in the now. Sound, liberated in the now. Taste, liberated in the now. Touch, liberated in the now. Sight, liberated in the now. Odor, liberated in the now. Scent, liberated in the now. Music, liberated in the now. Tools, liberated in the now. Tools, liberated in the now. Robots, liberated in the now. Fences, liberated in the now. Cabinets, liberated in the now. Beds, liberated in the now. Shoes, liberated in the now. Sandals, liberated in the now. Toothpaste, liberated in the now. Towels, liberated in the now. Toilets, liberated in the now. Sinks, liberated in the now. Showers, liberated in the now. Kitchens, liberated in the now. Chairs, liberated in the now. Videos, liberated in the now. Movies, liberated in the now. Shows, liberated in the now. Art, liberated in the now. Culture, liberated in the now. Culture, liberated in the now. Schools, liberated in the now. Universities, liberated in the now. Colleges, liberated in the now. Jobs, liberated in the now. Careers, liberated in the now. Position, liberated in the now. Status, liberated in the now. So we're getting close to the end of this video here, so we can wrap it up, get ready to wrap it up. And again, another practice to cool down is, I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. I am not a body, I am free. I am still spirit exactly as God created me. Hey, here's one. Bills liberated in the now. Bills liberated in the now. Debt liberated in the now. Debt liberated in the now. We can all try that one, can't we? Bills and debt, we can try it. Debt liberated in the now. Debt liberated in the now. Indebtedness liberated in the now. Harassment.